Yo, welcome back, Seat Story Day 3. We're here on the B stream, and we got Radu going up against Wacky Chan.
Yeah?
I've accepted that we should be calling him Wacky Chan after seeing his decks, and I hear there's some Frost Giants in Shaman.
Yeah, yeah. Jackie always plays, like, really... Yeah, I mean, there's no other word for
unconventional.
It. Unconventional. It's
just wacky. Unconventional,
wacky is,
yeah.
Wacky is the perfect word for it, so... Wacky Chan, Radu was actually, he told me that he was struggling to find a deck to ban because there was just, he didn't have Warlock or Warrior, so it was just nothing like
straightforward. Yeah, because Radu actually went ahead and prepared for real decks.
Yeah, pretty
and
much.
Then, and now he's playing against the Wacky Chan.
So I'm actually not even sure if RDU is favored in this matchup because...
Do you have any experience playing Frost Giant Shaman?
Yeah, like, I play it all the time, yeah.
Yeah, so... when you just... don't have any practice against, like, well, you've never practiced that matchup because you've
it's
never
like
seen that deck, so it's just
like the Bog Creeper factor.
You yeah.
Just... Oh. Actually, in the game...
we're bugged.
But I don't have anyone on my friends list.
It's a friendly challenge. I can't spectate. Yeah, we have some technical difficulties.
Anyone in chat have RDU's battle tag by chance?
Yeah, I can't spectate. Alright, you know what? This is off to a great start.
Yeah.
I mean, at least you look good.
Thanks.
Yeah. Yeah, we can't spectate.
We just don't, I don't have him on the friends list.
Yeah, we're just crushing this. And I don't even have a beer yet. This sucks.
Is it 4 p.m. yet? No. Is it? It doesn't show on the...
What in the... yeah, it is.
It is 4 p.m., yeah.
Oh, my God.
We get free beer after 4 p.m.
And I'm sober. Oh! I got in there.
Yeah, I just don't have... Okay, there.
Yeah. Oh. Yeah, get in there.
He's busy and... Okay, there we go. Okay, there we go.
We did it, team. We did it. And opening hand.
Oh, they actually just started. Okay.
Yeah. Yeah, we haven't missed anything.
And those are three very unconventional cards in Jackie's.
Well, they're elemental and ancestral spirits, like kind of like half standard, you know.
Yeah, I guess by now maybe.
Yeah.
Like I think pre-seat story they were not. They were both
it's
quite
like
wacky.
Stuff like I experimented with a lot of people kind of like dipped into. No.
Oh my god, dude. There's the Faceless Shambler as well in Jackie's deck.
That makes sense. It gives your like 0 mana 8/8 taunt too. And you get 60 power.
The deck just like feeds off Farsight and Emperor Thorsen just to make the wacky combos.
It's looking like. Like, there's no minions in RDU's hand, so, like, without the minions, like, his hand just doesn't really do anything. And,
yeah, but he has a few draws for it, right?
Yeah, for sure.
That one,
that was really good. But, like, in the early game, like, Jackie just wants to be hero power, because he's got Things from Below in his deck, and Frost Giant. I'm assuming just Things from Below, because...
Yeah. you would guess that even the 0 mana 5/5 makes it into the deck.
Yeah, yeah. The card's good. But yeah, in the early game, you just want to be pure.
You just don't,
because
you also run like elemental destruction, I'm guessing, and stuff like that. So you just have zero early game and just come back with that.
And like, what's cool about Shaman is like, that hero power is like discounting your late game, but it's also like tank up like from Warrior in the early game, because it's just like, your opponent kind of has to kill them because they have spell power, they have taunt.
Well,
it's just like the healing totem you can.
Yeah, the healing totem you can just leave up.
And the 1/1's just like kill one. But overall, like Shaman's hero power actually. Very much resembles a Warrior Hero Power.
Yeah, I mean the 1/1 actually can give you board control, right? Like here.
Well, your opponent has 2 1/1s, so like...
Yeah, but not board control, but like it's better than armor in this case, right?
So I think RDU is like going for like the second Innervate draw here, right? That's what he's going for?
Yeah, I mean you just kind of had to play it, like the other play was Hero Power and... Shaman, like what is Shaman going to do to actually kill it? I mean, are you going to Hex it? Jackie has to be scared of Nourish, actually. That's like a complete blowout.
There's a Fanrel on the board. You gotta be scared about like 8 to 10 cards in Radu's deck.
Like what? I mean, like Wrath and Living Wisps are not.
Idols, a bummer.
would he not have coined Idol there? I think
double
coin.
Innervate Scenarios is a real bummer.
Yeah.
That's the Nourish you're talking about. Yeah,
yeah,
that would
yeah, but he does get the Hex out of the way, which is a really big deal as well.
Yeah. Well, in Yogdra, there's actually not that many big guys.
I think you run like Ancient of War.
Run a one of Ancient War. Usually you run
if he went
Anixia, Scenarios.
I think he's not running the Life Coach list with no Yogg. Because it doesn't run Feral Rage.
Oh,
I know both him and both Life Coach and Tyson are running the no Yogg list.
But there's still like a limited number of big guys, and like,
yeah, Sylvanas. I guess Sylvanas is not that threatening. Right?
No, it's just like it hits two for two more, but
yeah,
Fenrir's like way scarier.
Yeah, yeah, and you do have Elemental Destruction, which is like,
and
almost good enough to kill most things.
Jackie's getting there. That Frost Giant's weighing in at 8 right now, squeezing a few more.
It actually kind of makes sense, right? So kind of Frost Giant.
Don't overthink
this. It's just kind of good, right?
You're gonna injure your brain before your match if you start thinking about this. Alright, can he deal with this and develop? He has two innervates, so for sure you can. You can just go like teacher and make some tokens clear.
Yeah, you can, and you don't have like a nourish where you can just pass the turn and be fine with it.
Like the innervates aren't that good anymore, anyways, right?
Right.
At this point, you already have like. Lots of mana. You still have a
going for like a huge Vile Teacher turn isn't really that valuable against this type of shaman.
Yeah, and like this is like the first turn you can do it.
But
it's
are you really swipe Wrathing here to protect a frog in a 1/1?
It's more about like skipping the turn and.
No, but that's literally what you're doing. You're just protecting the frog in the 1/1.
Yeah, but you're also developing.
You could Wrath for one to cycle one.
You're also developing though, right?
No, like what? Oh, the you double innervate Vile Teacher.
You're making a big board.
You double innervate Vile Teacher. Well, do you play that advisory first?
I guess, like, worst comes to work. I don't know Jackie's list card for card, but potentially there's, like, Karen on 6, and you have Sylph and one Hex the other way, so that could just letting it go and letting him develop could actually work out.
He might not even have time
factor.
At this point, so he's just going to hear a card.
Yeah.
Well, he decided on that, I'm guessing. Even if he wanted to, he could at that point.
Goes ahead and kills that totem.
Yeah, reduce the value of Solemn Vigil.
Oh. That's good draw, right?
Yeah.
I think you do that.
Yeah, seems good.
And then you play the spirit on it. You build your.
Oh,
own.
Do you?
I mean,
dude, I'm just looking at this Frost Giant here.
Immediately, it's your best play. I will admit the ancestral does get better, right? But immediately, it's your best play.
It's probably good enough, right? Well, he doesn't do it.
Pretty greedy. I don't know. I don't mind it either way. The problem is, like, I guess if, like, your opponent swipes this, right? That's his whole turn gone.
Yeah, if you plays, like, Ancient of War here, then the Ancestral feels really bad.
And next turn he's just gonna, like, totem and Giant.
I mean, Ardeus just hasn't applied much pressure, so he can kind of afford to take his time, maybe. I mean, that's what he's thinking, but I also have no idea what he's running in the rest of this deck. I mean, at this point, it could be a Reno deck, like that, for all we know. So,
I think I'm gonna go ahead and give him the benefit of the doubt and say he probably knows what he's doing more than
we're
speculating.
Yeah, yeah. Despite him playing unorthodox, perhaps weak decks, he actually has had quite some success, right?
Yeah.
Both on ladder and in tournaments.
Yeah,
I think,
he does well on ladder with this stuff, and he gets good at playing. Let's go ahead and say bad decks, yeah.
Yeah.
But he plays them really good. I'm ready to learn. I wait for no one. I'm ready to learn. So, what he could have done for the Doomsayer last turn just ends up connecting on the 5/5, so. Yeah. Pretty good. Ooh. Do we do stuff this turn? Or, like, do we play an 8/8? 8/8 seems pretty weak, right?
Yeah, because you can,
like,
you can Ancestral it on the following turn. He doesn't Farsight, so he's actually playing the
I think he's going to Farsight now.
Farsight now? Oh.
Yeah, because of the Spellfire. Killing that teacher is really good.
Oh, so if he doesn't roll the Spellfire totem, he plays the Frost Giant.
I think so.
But if he rolls it, he plays Farsight.
So either way, you're toteming first, so you get this information. Oh, he just got that.
That makes sense, right?
We have not seen a 2-of.
Yeah, but it makes so much sense to play 2-ofs in the deck. And Shaman already has access to healing with, like, Healing Wave. Why would you reduce the power of your deck?
But
it's more wacky, I guess, to play Reno.
This looks like a Scenarios pump turn, right?
It looks like it.
Like, that's a lot of value.
But
holds off, just plays the Emperor.
I think he's expecting like Elemental Destruction or Lightning Storm to be in his hand.
Yeah, but that doesn't actually
at the very least.
If that does not kill the Cenarius. I don't know.
Yeah. It would have actually probably won in the game if he did it here.
Oh yeah,
because he just doesn't
have
it.
Look at this hand and be like, why did I do that?
But...
Well, that would have been a lot of high rolls, right?
Yeah, yeah.
So overloaded for one, so no Ragnaros coming out this turn. Oh gosh. Still no 2-0s. Like you just said the Reno idea, and I'm convinced it is though.
Oh man, there's no way, right? It seems so bad.
Well, he's drawn what? He's drawn 12 cards.
Yeah, but all the 2-offs are so, like, it's a combo deck. Like, it's combinations of cards, so just having 2-offs of everything, it's so much better. It's like running 1 Force of Nature, 1 Savage, you know. I guess it was a thing at some point.
Yeah, yeah. But it took us a while to figure out that. Yeah. Wait, we consistently kill people way faster if we play 2 of each. Especially the Savage.
It's like running 1 Frost, never 1 Doomsayer.
No matter what, like, the Emperor's sick in here, so that sucks. Right, just gonna go ahead and make 2 7-7s and a third 7-7 with the
Ancestral. Definitely does not work on the Faceless Chandler, right?
Well, you get a 1-1.
Yeah, you get a 1-1 taunt, right?
Yeah, yeah.
So you probably pick the 7-7.
Yeah, I actually just thought about that after he did it. I probably would have put it on the taunt minion and lost.
Shame conceded, probably.
Oh yeah, for sure. Just like probably unplug the power on the computer, make sure it's like no one saw this. Still looking like Cenarius Pump here, but
he might want to develop the Sylvanas to. Cause it's generally good against Deathrattle minions, but
and you just not attack then, or you swipe,
oh, yeah,
you swipe and trade in. Like the Emperor discount, like
it might even Feral Rage, like it might just be better than swipe.
Because
swipe's more valuable later.
Hey, let's just save an extra 1-1.
And I don't think your HP matters much in this matchup.
No. You definitely. I definitely like. The Cenarius Pump's nice because you get 3 attack minions and then you have like Innervate, Feral Rage or Innervate swipe for 4. I don't think he's shipping 3 of the 3/3s. That just kind of like feels bad, you know?
Yeah.
Actually, if you do it this way, he has a full clear like this, but.
Full, yeah, I mean, I don't
think. I think you're going base.
I think you're going upstairs with those minions, yeah.
Like, that's a 4 mana 7/7, but it's like.
I think you take a line that just
7/7.
Gives you a really high percentage to just win the game.
Yeah.
Frost Giant not looking so hot right
Jackie
now.
Jackie has to, like, storm and heal, so he can't, like, roll for Spellfire. Kind of bummer. You just high roll, right?
High roll every single token.
You have a choice?
Not with the Feral Rage in hand, but he might go for the. I mean, the totem is also super low percentage to even give you the Spellfire.
Yeah, exactly.
And this way, even if you don't high roll on everything, you can still just Healing Wave and draw another AoE next turn.
And high roll on the ghost, too. And he does have Ragman the next turn. Oh my goodness. If only the overload effect actually counted in the jest.
Yeah.
That'd be good.
But now we've seen the 2 of.
Yeah.
It's not Reno. Probably.
I don't think we'll be seeing this deck again. Unfortunately.
What about like
what
Ancestral Knowledge into
what do you think about the
7/7
in this deck?
It makes sense, right?
I've played.
You're going for the big combo turns. And the 7, it's one. It's a big minion, and it's also like.
But it doesn't have taunt. That's my issue with it. And like, it's kind of like a beatdown card, and you're not at all a beatdown deck, right?
Yeah.
I like the synergy it does have with Elemental Destruction, though, because oftentimes people don't kill the 7/7, which means you can destruction kind of push with it.
That's synergy, I guess.
Yeah. Thunderstorm is. I mean, you're gonna have to high roll.
It's just game, right? Oh, he needs.
We don't know. Let's look at it from Jaggies. There's like no Feral Rage. So he has to high roll.
On every single. Yeah.
We missed. Darn. Yeah, you need to high roll the Ancient War and the 3/3.
And well, exactly.
Yeah.
Taunt Totem.
And he wanted to play Frost Giant because it was like. Oh, Totem. You just check if you'd get Spellfire. But the winning play was developing the 8/8 rather than like going for the Spellfire Totem, I think.
Yep, for sure.
Just like way too far beyond at that point.
So it didn't really come together with the draws there. I don't know what type of card draw he runs, but he didn't. He definitely had like some weak turns.
He missed all of it, yeah.
Does he even run it though? Like this deck seems very different to like the Frodan Bog Creeper Shaman.
Yeah, there's the 7/7s in there.
I guess you run the Manatide.
The Frost Giants in there.
Probably run the Manatide or, no, maybe not. I don't even know.
Yeah. Hard to guess. We got.
He's queuing up his mage.
I must protect the
with Ragnaros and Mana Worm.
Tempo Mage. Tempo Yogg Mage, I would guess.
Oh, and he's doing pretty good so far. He's got like double Mana Worm. Do you keep Intellect? It's like mediocre. But, like.
He doesn't, but I think I wouldn't mind it.
Yeah. It's like.
He also runs Rag in the Tempo Mage, though, so maybe it's like higher value.
If you're like a little higher curve, then drawing cards is a bit worse. You'd rather be jamming your big guy every turn. But when like you open double Mana Worm, you have this tendency to run out of cards because you already like you play 2/1 drops, right?
Right. So. And you're also very likely to draw 2-drop, like even if you throw away the Arcane Intellect. With like Cult Sorcerer, Sorcerer
Apprentice.
Yeah, you
play 4. Sometimes the Blood Mage makes a cut.
Right.
Blood Mage is like a reasonable card in Tempo Mage, is it for sure?
RDU doesn't keep Fandral. Makes sense.
Oh, that's actually like a very nice opening for RDU. It just like lets you deal with Mana Worm and like gain a bit of tempo, except when the Metzels is there.
Yeah, he just. Or does he? He does, right? Or do you wait a turn and go double Mana Worm? Coin missiles.
I think waiting's actually like the best play.
Yeah, but it sucks against Power of the Wild. That's the issue.
Yeah.
I really would be surprised if he waited.
What to do?
What to do? Tricky. It's pretty sick to wait. It's a pretty sick play.
Yeah, there's like, it's high reward, right?
Yeah, but he's already like.
If you just play one and
with this hand,
powers,
you need to go for the risk.
Do you?
Like the reward is like maybe like a +1.
You have 2 fireballs, so if you get those Mana Worms going quick, like you could probably close up.
Yeah, but you still do even with this play. It's just, oh, he plays double Mana Worm instead.
Yeah. Well, that was
oh, no, no, he doesn't.
No, he doesn't miss the play.
He plays a missile.
Plays around Power of the Wild. Oh boy. I guess it doesn't matter. Because, like, Power of the Wild is no longer a play, right?
Nope.
Well, yeah, it is. You make a 3-2, right?
Yeah.
Which is actually going to be, like, super awkward for Jackie.
Yeah, unless he draws. I mean, there's quite a few draws that are good.
Frostbolt, second. Blast, Missiles.
Why is Missiles even that
Mirror
good?
Image.
Mirror Image, yeah.
There.
Oh my god, that's
the best one.
It's the best one out of all
and
those.
You get to play the second Mana Worm. I think you go face,
and
right?
RDU doesn't have a play.
Like, I already think you go face in general, but your hand's double Fireball, so...
Yeah,
you go face.
Oh.
Feels better, man.
And he doesn't even have a swipe, like, he doesn't even have a future plan to kill it, he's just...
At least for Radu, like, Jackie's hand's double Fireball. The double Fireball's, like, really bad news for RDU, but, like... It might mean like Jack has
in
like.
In the immediate next turn, it's not that good.
Yeah. But I wouldn't be surprised if, like, say, like, RDU plays, like, Fandral on 4, right? I think the Fireball might actually just go upstairs.
Really? I mean, the Fandral just kills the Mana Worm.
Yeah,
right? I think you have to kill it because you would do it if it was, like, if the Druid had, like, Brawl or something, right? But if the Druid didn't kill on the previous turn, like, he's probably not going to kill it on the next turn either.
How much damage is coming in?
He hits the. Oh.
He's playing to his outs.
That's really, really, really playing to your outs.
Well, that, yep.
And Jackie would probably assume swipe, right? Even though RDU doesn't have it, he would definitely assume swipe here.
Oh, well, yeah, that's. It could also mean. It's definitely not wrap here if I were to wrap.
It makes sense to Frostbolt for 5 damage here.
Oh, yeah, for sure. And that says something lethal as well, so.
Yeah.
Well, you wrath, so you're...
You wrath for 1.
Do you?
No. I mean, maybe, like...
You
no.
wrath for
no,
1...
No, you don't
no,
have
no,
that.
No. You wrath for 1, you hit the second wrath.
Yeah, that's what I meant.
Yeah, like, yeah.
The thing is that you...
That's
there's
the
only so many cards you can have in his hand, like, you know, like, Azure Drake's Rag. Like, maybe that's what you hope for. Like, if he has Fireballs, and like, maybe you just can't win either way. Which you actually cannot.
I mean, regardless of what Jackie's hand actually is, that Frostbolt Fate's just a good play.
Yeah, 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 for sure.
Like, it's just pressures and... Yeah. You just have to hit the second grab, right?
I mean, it's so...
You can also hit...
It's so optimistic.
You can still hit Innervate and...
Can you really, like, absolutely not win if you Wrath for 3 and you just Hero Power? If you hit, like, Raven Idol into Feral Rage and stuff, or Healing Touch?
No, already agrees with you. Two Mana Worms, two Frost Bolts, yeah. Two Frost Bolts.
That is what someone would call the Apex Void draw of Tempo Mage, where they just hit Mana Worm and just...
Well, he would have had Innervate last turn, so the Wrath for one would have had, like, would have been rewarded, but...
Yeah, that's just game.
Yeah.
Can't beat that.
That was really good.
I can see.
Nah, that's insane. That's like two Mana Worms. And people complain about Tunnel Trog, right? Like, look at that card. Look at that card, yo. Yeah.
Series tied up 1-1.
What do you counter queue? Zoo, right?
I think the current tempo, like the post-standard tempo mage, is just really weak against Zoo.
Yeah.
Even though it's good before, the expansion just isn't anymore, so. I don't know why that is. It's
do you,
like, my
do you remember
scientist.
What RDA's warrior was? Was it the dragon?
Dragon warrior.
Yeah, that does well. Like, what? Like the idea that Mana Worm gets Alex.
I guess maybe
champion.
He might want to save the zoo for druid because it's like a better matchup. Even if the zoo is better against tempo mage, then beating the druid with the zoo could be.
All right, he agrees with you. Takes the warrior.
Might be like just like an equally good matchup. I'm really not sure. Like, I mean, Alexstrasza Champion and War Axe obviously are very good against most of the minions. I guess having
Fairy Dragon's actually just insane as well.
Right.
Especially when you have the coin.
Unless they missiles. And hit the 50-50.
Yeah. Well, it's still like one for one. It's fine. And there's the missiles.
We hit the Mana Worm as well. Nope.
I don't even know if you want to play Mana Worm on a 1 in this matchup.
Mana Worm?
Yeah. If it just gets Alexstrasza's Champion, you're just, like, sad. And Alexstrasza's Champion is, like... Or Mana Worm is actually just, like, a late-game win condition.
I mean, with the mirror image draw, you 100% don't play it, but...
Yeah, you play it next turn, for sure.
Yeah.
Like... It's actually just, like, a late-game card. A 1-mana late-game card.
Yeah. It's not too late game though, like, you know, Black and Carpenter can start, like, if you save them until, like, turn 5, you know, then it's kind of reaching them.
You like playing them on turns your opponent doesn't want to spend 2 mana removing it, right?
Yeah. So he has a choice between Priest and Hunter.
So
I would probably pick the Priest, or...
Yeah. Well, the steady shot's, like, pretty good if you're planning on starting to be winning.
Yeah, it's just that he doesn't have, like, too good of a read on how the game's going to pan out. Cause
yeah, for sure.
And the heal is...
The heal's...
It's just the board control plan, right?
Like, the heal plays around, like... But your opponent, like, not being able to anymore do something like Frostbolt, leave your guy at 1 kind of plays.
Sure.
Which don't always actually come up.
I think
Tempo
Mage is one
useful.
Of the decks, because they have so much removal, it's actually quite rare that you... Oh, my God. Okay,
we had the read wrong. Yeah. What just happened?
Okay, but Tempo Mage
definitely... one that affects the board the most.
Yeah.
For sure.
In the immediate turns.
Yes. He's looking at that execute. He's just...
I actually like this.
I like it a lot, too. He's actually just looking at turn 2, and he's just saying, well, my opponent's probably going to, like, play a 3-2 here, right? And what
right,
do I do?
There's 4 3-2s in that deck.
Yeah, so you just, like, dagger, hit it, turn your fill in. Makes sense.
Yeah. I was thinking about it. I mean, in general, like, Rogue is not a hero power you'd want.
Yeah, it's in all the board-centric matchups.
But
like,
I was just
Rogue
like,
hero power is actually pretty good.
Yeah, and I was just looking at how the Hunter hero power would pan out, how the Priest would pan out. Like, I was going to say the Tempo Mage generally, like, because they have so much removal, they just full clear your minions anyway.
Yeah,
like, they
exactly.
have that power,
yeah.
right? So heal doesn't seem that good. And it's not that often that you just value trade and heal into their minions like you do against, like, Druid or something like that.
And to be honest, just, like, you don't want to be hero powering anyways, so not that high impactful.
Right, Rogue is like a hero power that lasts several turns.
Yeah, exactly. You just get that done once. If you do not want to be spending 4 mana.
Yeah.
That's interesting. Well, the fairy dragon's not going away. What do you think about black? There was that.
I would probably Arcanine's luck there. I mean,
I meant if you were committed to the missiles, is pinging the guy like better?
So if the first missile hits on the Finley,
then you're
the
you decrease the chance the fairy dragon dies. Yeah, so you ping it first.
You increase the chance that it dies, right?
No, if you don't ping first and it there's the Finley has 2 health.
Yeah,
pinging first is good.
Yeah.
Oh, here's that spell we were talking about with the priest here. Fire, you can't make this play because your opponent's priest.
Unfortunately, though, as I said, with the waiting with the mana worm, this is
the
perfect card into this.
This is just overall been a pretty rough start for Jackie here. We did see off the Mulligan; he does play Flamestrike. That's like certainly a card, especially giving Radu's hand that like could actually just get him back into it.
Sure, but I mean, yes, in the sense that they all have 4 HP, but Jackie's only on 5 mana at this point.
Yeah,
and also with
Azure Drake, he's gonna take a beating.
With Azure Drake, it's likely that he'll just have the refill anyway after the Flamestrike. It's not like Artie is running out of cards anytime soon.
No. I mean, it's just draw a couple cards and ping. Or do you want a Mana Worm draw Blast? And that gives you a lot of 3/3 on board?
I guess that's what he's considering.
Yeah, the 3/3 on board
is
actually pretty good.
Maybe try and go for some Flamewaker play, but I think you might just...
If you save the Blast, like the Flamewaker, the next turn's like better. But you already have the 6 drop, right? And this is like so sad for Jack. There's like the second Blackwing just waiting for this Mana Worm.
Yep.
Yeah,
it's brutal.
Yeah, it's just there's Flamewaker.
What's the best 3 drop? Like, is it like Ancient Blade Master, right? That could actually he has to double execute.
That's not great, but sometimes it's Flamewaker. The super late mana turns is always Flamewaker. Blade Master is insane though, yeah.
Blade Master, King Mookla would be okay. No, it wouldn't be that good on this board.
So Radu is just like giving the super respect to the
Flamestrike. Thinking that's how you lose.
Another consideration is if you're not heroing power every turn, the rogue hero power is like the same as the hunter hero power.
For sure.
It's 2 damage for 2 mana.
But you can board control with the rogue.
Yeah, exactly. You have an Arcane Blast left in your deck. I think like you go Drake and try to hit that. You can also you can hit Frostbolt as well, right?
Do you have another?
He's only used one. I think. Pretty sure he's only used one. Yeah, he's only used one.
Okay.
You can also hit Frostbolt, so. Oof. Like, I guess you can hit one mana spell, but.
Second mirror image or something like that.
Yeah, but that doesn't even kill anything.
It doesn't kill, but it just helps stall.
Yeah. So 8, 12, 13. The Flamewaker has to die. Like, that's like how RDU froze this game.
Yep. You should probably just Corcron and execute with the rogue
here.
Maybe you don't have to Corcron, though. You can just play Azure Drake.
I kind of like having the dragon, though. Yeah, for that, like that guy. But
I think this just sets up lethal, and you can't. Like, even if you Flame Strikes, you just have lethal anyway, right?
Yeah. You push 8 this turn, and then you'd have 7 next turn, so you'd have Exactus, yeah. Yeah. Just not like a really rough start for the Tempo Mage this game.
Yep. But it also might speak a little bit for the matchup as well. Like, it didn't feel like he had, like, the worst hand ever. I mean,
yeah.
It felt like even if he drew some of these early game cards, like, they wouldn't even have been that good, right?
Yeah, my instinct was actually to Q Zoo into Tempo Mage, but like, that was a beating.
But this one seems like
that matchup seemed better than Zoo. Like,
yeah,
that was insane. Like Tempo Mage can beat the Zoo, which is like a couple lucky missiles and an Arcane Blast.
Yeah, just go
off
with
you don't draw him Gang Boss.
If you manage to
Zoo,
clear their board somehow with like Flamewaker Coin Mirror Image, Flamewaker Coin Missile, stuff like that.
Yeah, for sure.
And you can make it back.
So Jackie is left on his Druid.
Yep.
a bit of, I guess, kind of a slower list with when you're playing the Wisp Guard.
Is he playing that?
Yes,
I haven't seen his list.
Yeah, he's playing that in Solo
Force. But I would guess that... Yeah, I mean, it's still Yogdruid, though. Like, it's...
There's still Yogg in there.
There's maybe two or three tech cards in it, probably. All right,
so you go ahead. I'm just looking already at Jackie's opening hand. So you see this Wadgrip, this Fandral, and this Wisps of the Old Gods. You go ahead and keep all of that, and you hit the inner of it.
You snap keep all three of them, yeah. Wild Growth,
you would actually snap keep. you would keep Wisps of the Old God in your field.
Maybe if I was just feeling my inner Jackie Chan, I would do it. Just feel the innervate.
I mean, that's like how you meme your opponent the hardest, right?
Yeah.
It's just like...
Maybe he's down 0-2. He's like, yeah, whatever. It's just
like, you cannot nut draw harder than that, right?
I don't think so. And especially against Dragon War, there's just no AoE or anything like that.
You get 6/3/3s and a 5/7. You never lose.
Yeah, pretty much never
Unless
lose.
Unless Fandral lies.
I don't think the stream has actually gone into the. I don't think the stream has gone into the game yet. Actually, they're just watching us. But Arty's played a Finley on turn one.
Picks a Mage Hero Bear.
He's got a War Axe.
Hey, we figured out production.
All right.
Yeah, no dragon though. Yeah. Oh, he would have hit the innervate.
Yep.
Oh man.
I think the Fandral dies though.
Yeah, most times the Fandral dies. Still no dragon, so a couple options here. It's like coin frothing, play a 2/3 or
call
the
War Axe. Coin frothing gets so punished.
But
I don't even know if you call it punished. That's just not something you play around at all. But like Fandral innervate wrath. I mean,
yeah, it's really good.
It's ridiculous.
The coin. Playing the 2/3 is probably fine.
Yeah.
The control worried me just tells me to equip a War Axe here, but the War Axe actually just doesn't help you set up the deal with anything that's not called Mire Keeper.
I think in this situation against Druid, the difference between a 3/3 and a 2/3 is not that big. And
yeah.
You know, just developing minions in general is good against...
Well, there's Soul of the Force, so... I think you probably need some more mana here, right? Do you?
I would think so. And I mean, one reason to equip the War Axe is that way you can develop Frothing next turn.
Yeah, exactly.
If he plays Mire Keeper.
The Fandral, like, there's an argument for it. You need Slam or you need, like, Champion into it. I think if you have Champion and War Axe, you probably just Champion in the face, right?
Yeah, exactly.
So in Jackie's mind, it's just like Slam and Execute are the good answers to this Fandral.
Bloodticker as well.
Bloodticker would
work. Bloodticker ping.
Yep. However, if you do go ahead and wrap this, then... I think this is like the highest risk, highest reward play you can possibly make this turn. Because next turn, you get the best of the both worlds with the Mire Keeper.
Yep.
And, RDU is just like, well, this Fandral's sticking around. That's cool.
Yeah. I mean, there's not a Nurse in hand at least, but even the Mire Keeper is quite...
Don't jinx it for RDU, man. Yeah, just go ahead and swing at this over a couple of turns, and...
Innervate.
It doesn't quite work.
I mean, it does...
Well, yeah, you go to 7, then you play Nyxia. Somewhere in between there, you have to kill that Frothing, because if you end Nyxia into the Frothing, like, you don't ever do that. Yeah, you just never do that.
I was thinking that the Innervate could maybe clear the Frothing with Hero Power, but...
Then you take away Innervate.
Your next turn is just so weak.
Yeah.
And there's a dragon for the Corruptor.
Yeah, you do that, right? Ecoin Corruptor.
And then the Frothing does not have an answer in Jackie's
side. I guess you could play a bit slower and you can actually just go like Champion re-equip here.
Champion
and then
re-equip.
Just go into like the Coin Mal Corruptor. It's like a different way of playing the curve.
Yeah, the Corruptor is probably still good next turn, but...
Yeah, oftentimes.
He has so few cards in it. I mean, maybe he's thinking about like Ancient of War or something like that.
You can't Ancient of War and leave the Frothing there, right?
Well, if he just has no other play.
He
doesn't have that many cards in
there. Yeah, I guess. Oh, remember when I said you probably shouldn't play Nyxia into the Frothing? I think we're going to see him play Nyxia into the Frothing here.
Yeah.
Always the top deck. You think you trade her?
Plays around like Savage Roar.
Barely.
A little bit.
Barely. You get one extra.
I would go face with that.
Play around and Nyxia to get face.
I mean, you have the War Axe for it.
Yeah. As long as you can eventually kill that, you have to play Nyxia. This is brutal.
It's happening. But, I mean, there's no Raging Ghoul.
Yeah, Jackie doesn't know that.
Unless
I'd be pretty scared.
Unless he draws it.
And the big boy play. Just drop the Onyxia.
This is 100% the winning play. That's what
you
have to
do. Oh, yeah. Well,
you have the Soul of the Force in hand.
Well, Ghoul successfully dodged. You got Hazard Drake, right?
Ah.
Did you start pinging this crap off?
You can clear the Onyxia. Like, what if you're just dead?
That's a very real possibility.
Like, you can clear the Onyxia.
I believe there's Soul of the Force and Savage Roar in Jackie's dead. In Jackie's deck. So you might just be dead here.
You could Alexios Champion and run the Black Encryptor
as
well into it. It feels quite bad, but you're also getting the face damage.
You
like,
can also keep
the
other two minions alive and trade the Frothing into the Onyxia, which clears just a bit more of the board.
That's
it leaves you with a bit more it leaves you with more HP too, right? On the board in terms of minions.
Yeah.
I like that a bit more.
And with the nature of Ardu's hand as well, that makes a lot of sense to go for that play.
Yeah. This play looks freaking horrible from Artie's point of view, but he's actually just kind of scared.
Yeah, that is the play that actually can win in this game.
Yep. So much respect for the meme deck. So, from Jack's perspective, you have like, the Soul of the Force is definitely coming out this turn, right? Do you do it with the Mire Keeper or the Vile Teacher?
I would think the Vile Teacher is better, and you only have one spell in hand.
Yeah. You get the same amount of value from the Soul of the Forest, right?
Yes, but you also develop a bigger threat, I guess.
And Artie is just like, how did I start losing this game?
Onyxia with Soul of the Forest.
Yeah. Yeah, that happened. I'd say
that's probably one of the better draws in his deck, but like,
I think that's better than the Drake. Like, you're staring down, like, 11 on board. You can reduce, like...
Unless he runs Whirlwind in his Dragon Warrior. Azurdic Whirlwind.
Oh, yeah. The Spellpower Warrior, man.
Sick play. We actually...
Whoa!
Gives him the...
Yeah, it's not really reducing.
That's a Trump trade if I've ever seen one.
Yeah, I don't know about that one.
There he is. Yeah, Jackie's not gonna, like... Oh, be ahead and, you know, like, yeah, what, there's no reason to play. Like, he's playing that card, right?
He's not ahead. Like, this is, like, still a very, very close game. And,
okay, yeah. It's fair enough. And Yogg is actually really good when it's, like, kind of, like, even back and forth as well. Like,
yeah, for sure.
As long as you're not, like, 100% winning the game.
His spell count's not crazy. And Yogg's a good card because it's just... The spells are slightly positive overall.
No, for sure.
So... That's why you play the card.
I mean, more than slightly positive.
Yeah.
That's... Stanley. Okay.
More war
access. Probably hoping for the Gladiator's Longbow there. But
he needs a single Mind Blast for Lethal. Can he do it?
I believe. I think Artie knows what's happening. He looks up in Jackie's face sees him holding up his arms, preparing for the Yogg.
If you just go face with Violet Teacher and play another Lethal.
He's at a health total where he just...
He can't wait. Like, if you just go face for 6 here, you put him to 4 and you play another Violet Teacher.
He has
to clear both the teachers to not die.
If I was
this is just good.
If I was a Druid, I would be really expecting, like, a, you know, a Grom or something like that, or a Rag.
Well, yeah, but you're 26.
But you're still at...
You're 26, you're not a rush.
Yeah.
I like this play. All right, slam execute, keeps him in the game. Say slam execute, you hit the other teacher of the Malkorok.
You could just ding execute.
I think you kind of want to dig for that taunt.
You probably play the Azurdic first, though, or... Oh, you want to draw exactly the second taunt?
You want to draw for the taunt?
To play on what, though?
Getting Hero Power than Faceless. You definitely draw before you play Drake, because you want to play the taunt this turn, right?
Yeah.
And you need it next turn, so the slam has to come this turn.
You probably wouldn't even hit the 2/2 if you drew the 3/6.
Yeah, then you're not dead to living rooms.
Yeah.
Yeah, absolutely. I think you definitely start with the slam.
Jackie is just...
Not just in general, in the average Hearthstone turn, you usually kind of... You usually kind of start with your cheap draw.
Oh, he's going to slam.
He's going to That's
the most defensive line.
That's the most defensive line. I don't know if
it's on the previous turn check. It was just like poking his Yogg-like. He probably has some ritual for this Yogg-like. He's played this card so much, he knows exactly how to.
Artie has barely dodged Savagery. Do you just get him for three here?
I mean, I think you do, right? Like, oh, like, what?
Well,
if you start, you put into one, he doesn't have the warrior hero power. Like, it's exactly the
No.
This could backfire.
Oh no.
It's happening. It's happening. Yeah. It actually happened. I mean,
and praise Yogg.
I mean, he needed exactly the Twilight Guardian, right? There's nothing else, right? So you just could set up such a high win percentage line, and even if he draws the taunt, then you Yogg, right?
Twitch chat's happy though. Isn't that what really counts?
Yeah. I'm all for playing Yogg. It's just.
And actually, just Jackie.
I wonder
just,
if it was the.
Jackie goes ahead and rips the nourish, so he's like right back in it.
Yeah.
We still got a game ahead of ourselves now. Yeah. Like playing the living room seems like really bad, right? Like, you have the Savagery, so you kind of want to do it, but sometimes there's, like, a mage hero power and warrior.
Does he run the second Soul of the Forest?
Oh, what?
That would be a reason to keep it, but...
Yeah, for sure.
Especially with the mage hero power.
It's just, like, 1-1-1, right?
1-1-1, yeah.
Oh, wow.
There it is.
That is such a good turn.
There it is. It's harder for Jackie to go for... Oh, okay.
Yeah. Yeah. This is far from over. Well, new cards. I think you might want to like go with the Wild Growth this turn so that you can like set up a more of a. I think you need you're going to need the spell powers kind of for like a board clear at some point.
Does he have a swipe left?
I'm not sure. We just saw one.
I think he does.
I think he does too, because remember the whole frothing and Nyxia thing? He had all those turns he didn't have swipe, right?
Right.
To kill that frothing.
Yeah.
Goes ahead and mulches a free six.
What is that card?
New card. Swap stats with another minion.
RTU is trying to figure out how this card works.
Yeah, is.
You can make your Azure Drake a 3/6.
Are you, of course, not a native English speaker, still taking his time reading the card?
Yeah. Bringing out the Google Translate to figure out exactly what the words mean.
I think it actually, it might be the play this turn. You can...
And how sick is that card with Acolyte? Just make it a 3/6.
Dude.
That's not even good.
No, you just figured it out. That's exactly what you need
to
be doing.
Okay.
That's what you need to be doing with that.
What else is there? Like,
you can make a 3/6 charge.
Effect, so, Well, it's kind of, yeah. It doesn't really matter that it has charge. You can just do it afterwards. But you probably do it on the Azure Drake, right? It has, like, the biggest benefit.
Wait, remember that whole conversation about the, like, 30-0 minion? Would this work? No, it wouldn't work.
You need some insane APM for that to work.
Well, giant-ass board, no Yogg for Jackie left. Got a Raven Idol and a Dream, though.
Can Raven Idol do it? What does he even need? Old Force of Nature.
I mean, there's only 16 on board, right? So, you're not bad.
Old Force of Nature would do it.
Old Force of Nature?
Yeah, it'd be the combo for night.
Just go back to 2015 for a little bit here and win the game.
Yeah, I was saying this earlier. Like, they should make a card that just discovers...
Oh my god. Does this Starfire just go phase here?
Yes.
That's the big boy play, right?
Yeah.
Play to win.
Yeah,
you're dead. You're dead to like Rag, Grimash.
You're pushing to six. You actually have Savage Reliving
for
six. You're one off.
With the Drake.
You're one off. Can you maybe?
He's at 11, right? You put him. You Starfire and your Hero Power. You actually put him to 5.
Oh right, yeah.
Then you set a label.
Yeah.
You can also take the Wrath and like go for like Drake Wrath. But is that like ever good enough? You're so far behind on board.
Just do it.
And he also has the Roots.
Didn't move my mouse.
Yeah, he also has the Root, so he gets to clear two of these minions. So it just leaves a 6/6, so he's not like dead to one of the two big
boys.
That's
the board control play, and I think that maybe...
The problem with this play is, like, you were dead to, like, the big boys, right? But, like, if your opponent has big boy here, you just lose anyways.
Right, like the Rag or Grom.
Yeah, if he has Rag or Grom, you're just dead. Oh, not... You're, like... that kind
well,
of
if you had, yeah.
Yeah, I would have Starfire my opponent.
That was like the risky play, but I had a pretty high percent to win.
Yeah.
Because compared to the other line, because...
Yeah. This is like play to...
This
line like
still loses.
This is like... This is just play to survive another turn.
Right, but it's playing... To, yeah, exactly. So you survive one more turn, but it's not the winning line, really.
He's probably playing Old Forest Nature in his deck, though.
Yeah. I was saying earlier, we should... Like, there should be some card of Hearthstone that could discover the pre-nerf cards, you know?
Yeah.
Like, it'd be a pretty terrible card, like, you know, stat-wise, like, maybe, like...
The card design on that is just awful as well, but it'd be funny.
5 mana, 3/3 or something like that, but you discover a meme, and it just, like, you just have, like, Old Warsong Commander.
Old Forest Nature. Old Leprenom.
Yeah.
I guess... Are you comfortable taking 4 here?
Oh, that's sick.
Oh, yeah. That oh, my God. RDU is figuring out how to use the new cards.
That card actually sucks so bad, though. Like, look at the card itself, right? Like, it's not like it gives 3/6 to another man. It makes itself the 4/3. So it's like,
yeah.
That card sucks, man.
RDU just figured out how to use that card, man.
Yeah. I mean, that was a decent use of it, yeah.
So now there's like 10, 12, 15, 16 on board.
He needs the swipe, right?
Yeah, he needs the swipe. There's two, 10, 12, 15, 18, 19 on board, excuse me. Oh, another Roots kind of gets to do like exactly the same turn, but every turn that passes, he's just like taking some damage and getting a little lower. Whoa, Wrath going upstairs.
Oh, that's a card you could discover, right?
Like, oh, this swipe just a little. Oh.
Oh, no.
That's a bummer.
So you power the Leopard Panther.
So there's 8, 11 on board. 12 on board, you're dead to 2. Hey, but going face of the Starfire, right? Now you're just like in the exact same position you were last turn, just with like less health again.
It could be a case of the caster goggles, though, you know, seeing what Arthur has.
And there he is. Does that do it? Sometimes it does it, right?
It's exact.
You can ping the Drake and
you can clear with the War X.
Yep.
So RDU wins the series. Pretty exciting series. Unfortunately, we didn't really see like the Frost Giant and stuff like that really coming.
Yeah, we didn't quite see Jackie's full master plan.
Yeah.
But the master plan exists, and you know that, right?
And was that the winner's match? It was, right? That was the winner's match. So RDU
was the winner's match.
RDU makes top 8.
Congrats to RDU. Pretty good first tournament for Jackie overall.
Was the winner's match. He's still in.
Yeah. Oh, my bad.
Yeah, he's still in it. He has one more chance, and I think it's...
It's
Hot Form, I think.
Just saying against Hot Form?
Yeah, I think so. The previous match, yeah, it's on here. Yeah.
That was a good series.
Yeah, it was good.
I wish RDU actually just kind of lost to the Giants, but didn't quite happen.
Oh, RDU looking pretty happy, sipping some water over here.
All right. Well,
he's looking at me in a weird way. Okay.
Yeah.
We'll just. Are we going to a break now? I don't know how to do this.
Too much eye contact. All right. We're going to be going to a quick break, guys. There's going to be probably Hot Form against Just Saying just coming up after this. Don't go anywhere, guys. More C Story Cup.